sitting there saying, you need it, you have it available. Alright, for radiation, always disable the transmitter switch before approaching the radome. It's a big... If you guys have any questions or everything while I'm talking, please ask me. So we're also going to do some network architecture. The components on the same system. It's a really nice capability. Also, you have FTP capability on the system, just like on our EWR. We'll talk more about that later on. The local and remote user. It enables them to have control of your scan strategies, as well as product generation. It works as a backup battery for the system, as well as filters power on. So the system is very susceptible to bad power. If it gets bad power, it can really burn it out easily. So you use that to filter the power. So you are, a lot of times when you're downrange, you're gonna be on generators or not exactly the best power like here in the States. So for that reason, radome, you're gonna have your receiver and transmitter. It's gonna be a solid state receiver and transmitter. What that means is it doesn't break often. It's very nice for you. You don't really gotta do too many checks on it. It's all underneath here. So what you're gonna be doing for your, that you can use, so you'll tell that to your frequency manager. It's just like every other system we've talked about. You gotta get frequency approval for it. So you'll tell them that frequency and they'll give you a frequency inside that range. Now, out, not only is it going to hurt them, but it might hurt the system. They might pull it over, and especially if they run it over the vehicle, just have it marked. Alright, here's a picture of the Weather Scout program, which is what you guys will be using as your if you don't hit the shutoff button, it's going to burn itself up. So it's very, very important for you guys to A, watch its system is actually larger than normally would be on a pallet if they had the entire thing. So what they did was they cut it down. Thank you. While we have it at this point right here, you also want to check the waveguide. This is a flexible waveguide here. Just from the amount that
rotates freely, take that big red X off, and make sure that it tilts too. And check your wave guides. Make sure if you pull. This, we take turns on this, using that little thing to so stand around watching as it is.
As they come over, you're just gonna help and maneuver it on here. Okay, a few people, so if I can get someone to, over here to help direct.
There we go.
Awesome. There we are. We're gonna leave the red X on for right now. Tilt plate has your nice north marker on there, so just make sure to point that north. We have the ocean behind us here, so we know that the north is this direction. Stand it up. Make sure. sure the valve here is pointed northwards, so turn it a little bit. Two sections, you're gonna lower it down. Make sure they sit firmly on the ground. Awesome.
Yeah. Usually I only get to set up the ground part of the garbage train. So I help out in the morning when they're doing the setup and tear down the nails and dump car.
What this is at the top here, you guys have these cannon plug, and it is all that's attached up here to the pieces. So it attaches. In fact, this pair, as I said before, I'll go on the front side here. On that black rope. Awesome. Check your tautness. The way we're going to do that is you're going to take the rope, you're going to take your finger on top, and you're going to bend it. We got a little bit of bend in this one, so I get everyone to check. Do that fancy though. That's right.
Better not mention that again.
All right. And what I need is, Gertrude's got it. Need a person back here to make sure that these ropes go up out there.
Up for
you. Oh, there it goes. I was like, oh, you did get Jim, didn't you?